Hello, on this Wednesday midweek, talked about this last month when we reached a new peak for carbon dioxide levels. The daily average peaked at 421 parts per million at the Mauna Loa Observatory and 419 for the monthly average. And April is the peak, naturally, in our carbon dioxide emissions. You can see that it peaks in the Northern Hemisphere spring and then reaches a minimum in the Northern Hemisphere summer and early fall. And the reason for that is photosynthesis. There's more trees, more forests, because there's more land in the Northern Hemisphere. This is looking at atmospheric carbon dioxide from space in April. So look at all that orange and red. That's carbon dioxide floating around the atmosphere. And look at it in July and August. Big difference. Still high levels of carbon dioxide when we look at the average through the year, but photosynthesis does matter. The trees, the forests of the Northern Hemisphere in the summer months really does have an impact. And so that's why if we can reforest areas we've deforested, that can have an impact on reducing carbon dioxide emissions. Our upper level pattern is finally going to be changing around here. We've been talking about the slow warmth through this week. Well, that continues into next week. It's been a bizarre pattern of these ridges up towards Alaska and the West Coast, troughs here in the central and eastern parts of the country, very convoluted patterns in the upper levels, not the normal wavy jet streams, but just crazy, almost knots in the upper level pattern. That is starting to change here through the week and transitioning to a more summery-like pattern next week, which means more storms, which we need. We are behind on precip. So you can watch that upper level pattern become more conducive towards warmth. The reds and browns are proportional to warmth in the atmosphere. That lifts north. And then we get this positive tilt with a low in the southwest. That's going to create a stormier setup. And we are behind, not just for precip, but storms. Just a dozen events here in the Twin Cities area for year to date. The average is about 25, so about half the severe weather compared to normal. Now, we don't like severe weather, but thunderstorms are a normal thing here late spring into summer. And in fact, 70% of our rainfall comes from storms. So we do need those. And with this cooler pattern, that means less precip. But that upper level low we're gonna watch next week moves to the southwest. That's gonna throw waves of energy at us. Also setting us up to get into a flow from the south, which is going to bring in Gulf moisture. Yellows and oranges here are dew points in the 60s plus. We need that. It's going to be stickier next week, along with warmer temperatures. So here's precip total the next 5 days, really confined to the southern half of the country where they've been flooding. So we need to spread that activity out in north. And it does look to do so next week. In fact, a big shift, not just in our temperatures, which are going to be nice, but also that stormier setup for some showers and thunderstorms. So here's precip for May 16th to the 21st, really spreading north in some much heavier amounts. So hopefully we can make up that deficit, which is more than an inch behind normal for rainfall in the Twin Cities for the month of May, which when we're not even halfway through the month, that's a big deficit to already be having. So we're going to try to make up for that next week. Couple of minor systems, though, until next week. Friday, most rainfall to our south. Couple of isolated showers here. Same thing on Saturday. It is going to be cloudier and hence just a touch cooler than what we'll see today and tomorrow, probably Friday, Saturday. But the real setup for more widespread showers and those thunderstorms and downpours comes later next week. And it is going to be warmer, as I mentioned, too. In fact, almost like a flipping a switch to summer. American model has occasionally been thrown out on 90 here within the next couple of weeks. We'll see if that actually happens, but either way, you get the idea. Things are going to be flipping to almost summer mode, and that's just kind of how it seems to go around here usually. Sometime in May, we just flip the switch. 67 today, lots of sunshine, just these few fair weather cumulus clouds popping up today and tomorrow, 70 tomorrow. Again, a touch cooler Friday, Saturday as we see some clouds and those very isolated showers, and then heading into next week, consistent 70s, and many of you have asked about overnight lows. Those are consistently going to be warmer too, not just frost free, but above 50 most nights.